nights away from the most exciting match of the year. Less than a week from the Royal Rumble. Welcome, everyone, live to Monday Night Raw. We are at the show in Detroit, Michigan. Michael Cole, the Hall of Famer, Jerry the King Lawler at ringside.
On tonight, two worlds collide. That's right. You see it. Edge, the world champion from SmackDown, goes one-on-one against The Miz, the WWE champion from Raw.
And tonight, after weeks of waiting, Melina finally gets her opportunity. Melina meets Natalya for the Divas Championship live tonight on Monday Night Raw.
What a huge night.
Yes, if you know me.
And ladies and gentlemen, we kick off Raw with the World Heavyweight Champion from Friday Night SmackDown.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the World Heavyweight Champion, the Rated R Superstar.
And I assume Edge is full of determination tonight after what happened this past Friday on SmackDown. It was Edge versus Justin Gabriel from the newly formed group, the Corre. Thanks to distraction from other Corre members, Wade Barrett, Ezekiel Jackson, and Heath Slater, Gabriel upset the world champion.
Well, there may be a smile on the face of Edge right now. He may be trying to play this off, but I can assure you, Edge is hurting because those same four men you mentioned, the Corre, attacked Edge after the match and left him laid. He's got to be hurting.
Edge versus Dolph Ziggler for the World Heavyweight Championship this Sunday at the Royal Rumble event.
Miz, you know what I don't feel like doing tonight? Waiting. Yeah, you know what? I've never liked waiting. I don't have a lot of patience. I don't like waiting at the DMV. I don't like waiting for the guy in front of me at the supermarket to pay by check. I don't like waiting in line at the airport metal detector for the guy in front of me to suddenly realize that his belt that's made of metal is in fact made of metal. I'm sick of waiting in vain, mind you, for Michael Cole to suddenly stop being a tool.
Glad you're back.
And I certainly don't feel like waiting right now. So, Miz, I tell you what, why don't you just come out here right now so we can get this champion...
Can I have your attention, please?
Here we go again.
I just received an email from the anonymous Raw General Manager.
And I'll bet you'll read it.
You've missed this, haven't you? And I quote, I know you're very anxious to have your champion versus champion match against The Miz, but I have officially scheduled that attraction for later tonight. Fortunately for you, I haven't forgotten about the disrespect you showed me when you were a part of the Raw roster. That's why I have arranged for a special exhibition right now. Edge, whichever of these three men throws you over the top rope will earn the advantageous position of number 40 in this Sunday's Royal Rumble match.
We're gonna have a...
Ring the bell, please.
A mini Royal Rumble right here, right now? Well, here they come!
And also Tyson Kidd. And again, if one of these men can eliminate Edge over the top rope, they'll gain the number 40 entry, the final entry into Sunday's Royal Rumble match.
Well, you see Edge with those taped ribs. That's it.
Well, there's Tyson Kidd eliminated because both feet hit the floor after going over the top rope. But Drew McIntyre takes out Edge. Now, remember, King, Edge won last year's Royal Rumble match. He knows what it takes to win this style of matchup. But he may not be any match here, injured ribs and all, from Friday night's attack just 3 nights ago by the Corre. It's Swagger. And look at Swagger.
Swagger saves Edge, but it's because every man for himself. No, Swagger's eliminated.
Yeah, just like the Rumble match Sunday, every man for himself. And now it's Drew McIntyre.
McIntyre with a well-placed kick right to those injured ribs.
The only individual left that could gain perhaps the number 40 entry position Sunday. Going for the future shot. DDT! And Edge eliminates McIntyre. An impressive display by Edge, thwarting the plans of our general manager.
Yeah. Much to your delight, huh, Cole?
Well, later on tonight, Edge is going to get his, because remember, he's got to go one-on-one with the WWE champion, The Miz, right here on Raw.
Well, thank you very much, anonymous Raw General Manager. Thank you for getting my juices flowing. And I'll go to the back and get ready for my match with The Miz, but first, I thought maybe I'd like to do something.
No. He's got his eyes on the computer. Well, now sit down, Cole.
Something I did last time on this show. Who here wants to see a smashed laptop computer?
Not me. Hang on, I do. There's no way. I do. What? Look at Cole. Is Cole actually going to protect the computer?
Oh, it's the new Nexus. And there's new
Sit down, Cole.
Trying to protect the general manager.
It's a computer.
You might have mentioned this game, but of course, the new Nexus with its leader, CM Punk. And as we've learned, the four men, Otunga, Harris, McGillicuddy. And again, the new member we saw last week, but again, a formidable group, perhaps a more formidable group than the original Nexus. Because these men believe in CM Punk.
These men have been totally, unequivocally brainwashed. What we've seen these guys endure at the hands of CM Punk, just to be a part of his group or whatever it is.
They believe in him.
How? Why?
It's like their shepherd.
In this world, only the strong survive. And the strong survive just not from being strong. They don't survive just from sheer willpower. The strong survive because they evolve. Last week, it was announced that the Royal Rumble match will now have 40 superstars, making it the biggest Royal Rumble match in the history of the Royal Rumble. So as I see my surroundings change, I adapt because I am strong. I see the Royal Rumble expand, so the new Nexus evolves. Last week, you saw the new Nexus expand with the inclusion of this man. Handpicked by my myself from Cardiff, Wales, ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Mason Ryan.
I only have one thing to say. Faith.
What do you say? Faith.
Faith. I don't think I could have said it more eloquently. Faith. These men you see before you in this ring are bonded by faith. And unlike John Cena, and unlike that faithless, fake, poor man's Nexus on SmackDown, the Corre, our faith come Sunday night will be rewarded because we will unite for the common good. We will unite for one common goal, and that is to see yours truly, me, the faithful CM Punk, become the winner of the 2011 Royal Rumble match. When I win the 2011 Royal Rumble match, not only will I go on to main event WrestleMania, but the new Nexus will become the most powerful group that the WWE Universe has ever laid their eyes on.
I'll be your Amadeus.
Well, we'll see about that.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, here is the group that CM Punk just called the, quote, poor man's Nexus. Wade Barrett, Heath Slater, Ezekiel Jackson on the left, Justin Gabriel. Members of the Corre. And as Barrett explained to us this past Friday night on SmackDown, he's not the leader of this group, King. It is a group of equals.
Well, hold on to your seat. This could explode any minute.
Let's just clarify something, Punk. The only poor man's Nexus is this shower of rubbish stood in front of me right now. See, the Corre? We're nothing like the Nexus. This is not some brainwashing dictatorship. This is about four equals.
And while at the Royal Rumble, the four of us, we'll try to win the match for ourselves. We will unite. We will unite in making sure we eliminate you, CM Punk.